something important has happened over the course of this crisis. Estimates of expected deaths have gone down by a lot. On March 31st, the White House estimated that even with social distancing policies in place, between 100,000 and 240,000 Americans would die of COVID-19. Dr. Deborah Birx, the White House's coronavirus response coordinator, said that that was, quote, our real number. Dr. Anthony Fauci, the nation's top infectious disease expert, recently indicated he now believes it will be more like 60,000. The University of Washington model, which has been cited by the White House, predicted on March 26th that assuming social distancing policies that stay in place till June the 1st, U.S. deaths by August would most likely be around 81,000. By April 10th, they had made many revisions to get to their current number, 61,500. Predictions for hospitalization rates have also proven to be way too high. On March 30th, the University of Washington projected that California would need 4,800 beds on April 3rd. In fact, the state needed 2,200. The same model predicted that New York would need 58,000 beds on April 3rd. It used only 15,000. It made sense to take precautions, but that may have come at a cost as there are concerns that patients with other conditions haven't gotten the care they need. So what is going on? Well, many experts believe that social distancing has worked even better than was predicted. But here's a theory, acknowledging we still don't know a lot about the virus. A group of Stanford scholars believe that the basic reason estimates of deaths have had to be revised downwards is because without an understanding of how the virus spreads and without widespread testing from the start, we didn't realize how many mild or asymptomatic cases that there would be. That means the denominator, those who have been infected, could be much larger than initial estimates, and therefore the fatality rate for COVID-19 is much lower. In March, the WHO announced that 3.4% of people with the virus had died from it. That would be an astonishingly high fatality rate. Fauci suggested a week later that the actual rate was probably 1%, which would still be 10 times as high as the flu. Since then, we have learned that many people, in some studies 50%, in some studies as much as 75 to 80%, don't have any symptoms. That means it's possible most people infected with the virus are not getting counted. Stanford's John Ioannidis believes that we have massively overestimated the fatality of COVID-19. He told me, when you have a model involving exponential growth, if you make a small mistake in the base numbers, you end up with a final number that could be off tenfold, 30-fold, even 50-fold. He points out that in some of the places with the best testing, the Diamond Princess cruise ship, the Italian town of Vo Eugenio, Iceland, Denmark, the numbers who are actually infected when adjusted for the U.S. population as a whole suggest a fatality rate that is actually similar to the seasonal flu. Based on limited testing data, he estimates that fewer than 40,000 U.S. deaths will occur from COVID-19 this season. Now, that is still a tragedy, and we should be glad that the work that we've done to abide by social distancing has done some good, though it has come at a price, of course. That said, no one knows the right answers. That is why we need the best data, and that's why we need to hear both from the mainstream voices and from dissenting voices. We have shut down the economy based on models, which is understandable because we worry about worst-case scenarios. But in science, models evolve with new and better data. President Trump says we don't need mass testing, but reopening the economy will depend crucially on mass testing. Or else, once controls are relaxed, we might see the infection soar again. South Korea has been able to tackle the virus without major lockdowns, in large part because it has handled testing superbly. The most urgent task for the federal government is to get widespread, randomized testing in place, gather the best data in the world, and make policy based on that. Otherwise, we will continue to fly blind through this crisis.